Today, we have with us Brian and Paul. They are the owners of Elite Combative Systems here in Indiana, Pennsylvania. Elite Combative Systems is a gym for mixed martial arts, Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, self-defense, and other kinds of training. So we're gonna have a discussion with them today, talk about different martial arts and why it is such an effective self-defense tactic and things of that nature. So Brian and Paul, welcome. Thanks for being with us.
Thanks for having us.
Absolutely. So why don't you first tell us a little bit about your backgrounds, what got you into the sport of Jiu-Jitsu, Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, a little bit about what it is, and then how this gym came to be.
I think Brian got me into Jiu-Jitsu. Okay. We were over at the YMCA playing flag football, and he mentioned to me, he's like, check out this move I just saw. It's called an Uma Pulada. I'm like, wow, that's pretty cool. He's like, you want to go learn Jiu-Jitsu? I said, yeah. So we looked for a gym and found a gym in Greensburg and went down to a gym owned by Professor Casey Leonard, Pennsylvania Combat Sports, started our training there, and that was the beginning of this infinite journey.
Okay. Cool. And when was that? What had you done before that? What got you started, Brian?
I started learning boxing concepts whenever I was 14. From my uncle, and from there I knew I had an interest in martial arts. I wasn't always the fastest kid, I wasn't always the best athlete. Then I joined the Marine Corps, and from the Marine Corps I ran into a couple of folks that trained jiu-jitsu, and one of them was a substantial amount smaller than me, and he armbarred me and I was sold.
Yeah.
So I was always kind of like a bigger, rougher kid, so I figured I could roughhouse that kid around wrestling. And that was not the case. And I learned about Gracie Jiu-Jitsu then, and from there I had a couple people I trained in, and I trained some no-gi and stuff like that while I was in the Marine Corps, some Russian combat sambo. From there, it's been quite the journey. It's been fun, and learning techniques.
So how long has it been then?
Since probably whenever we started training in a gi, I would say since 2011.
Beginning of 2011. Yeah, we were at the YMCA, kind of doing some stuff in the back rooms, you know, with special permission. Late in the year of 2010.
So you guys knew each other then, obviously, before.
Right. We grew up on the same road, so we're childhood buddies, and we both were in the Marine Corps.
You were both in the
Marine Corps. Yeah. And then I would say that those grappling concepts probably stemmed probably around 2003 from the Marine Corps, where I first learned about Gracie Jiu-Jitsu.
You guys were both deployed at one point, yeah?
Yes.
Where did you guys?
I had two tours in Iraq.
In Iraq?
Iraq.
All right, so you get back here after your service and your work and doing stuff. You start learning some other stuff around. You say, hey, you want to learn this. And you guys go down to Greensburg, start learning and, you know, advancing and doing your thing. So what was it about? So tell us a little bit. You mentioned the word gi. So first off, what is a gi?
Looking at it. Okay. It's the traditional garb that we wear in Gi Jiu-Jitsu. And Gi Jiu-Jitsu just means that you're wearing the traditional garb with the belt. And there's rank attainment.
Okay, so is the uniform that you're wearing, is that part of the activity? Is it used in the activity? Or is it just something that you wear because that's what you wear?
The Gi is used for training. It's a training device that allows you to have grips. Okay. On it, so you can feed into the lapels or have different cup grips.
Okay.
And what it does is it teaches you the placement of those grips, how to effectively break those grips and use them for control.
Okay.
So with this on, this is part of Jiu-Jitsu. There's also no-gi Jiu-Jitsu. They're like yin and yang.
Okay.
So basically, the gi has many more controls, so you have to be pinpoint with your escapes. Okay. And accurate with how you defend against it. As in no-gi, you got to be pinpoint with your application because you have less control, so your application has to be on point.
Okay, so now explain to me what Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu is even. So I'm someone, I don't know anything. I come in here and I see, and you say, hey, I do this martial art. It's called Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. My first thought is it's just a bunch of, you know, big tattooed guys punching and kicking each other, beating each other up. Is that Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu?
No.
Okay, so what is it?
Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu is a form of grappling. So grappling solely focuses on control, and Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu is the combat side of things that has the chokes, the joint manipulations that are tied in to those controls that regular grappling would teach you.
Okay.
So Western Pennsylvania alone is one of the biggest grappling states you know, in the States, and it's a good supplement, and it shows that combat side of things, teaching, like I said, those joint manipulations and those chokes.
So grappling, like wrestling, you mean?
Yeah, absolutely.
So it's wrestling, but you're not necessarily trying to pin someone, you're trying to choke them or manipulate
them. With a compliance technique, so you have some form of control to keep them compliant, and then there's always a close-handed submission that could potentially render them unconscious or, like I said, joint manipulation.
So it, again, a new person who's never done this, it's intimidating to walk into a place like this and see, you know, people rolling around. Can it be for anyone? Can someone with no experience, not necessarily someone who considers themselves, you know, very tough or strong or anything, actually do this?
Yeah, jiu-jitsu is for everyone, Steve. Regardless of who you are, where you come from, your body type, your athletic ability, you know, this is a sport that is truly for everyone. You hear us reference control a lot, and the first thing that most everybody learns when they come in is how to control themselves. Because if you can't maintain that self-control and that emotion recognition of, hey, I'm scared here, but I have to use these techniques to get through. There's a pattern to get through this. There's a way out of this. And establishing that, recognizing that self-control is the number one thing. So it's useful for any person to come in.
Is it a good form? Obviously, I would think a good form of self-defense. But does this stuff work? You know, out there, if there was a problem.
Absolutely. There's like a very large push for law enforcement to start implementing Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu into their defensive tactics programs. So what's nice about Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu is you're the deciding factor. You learn all these controls and these pins, and you learn how to control someone. So to me, that means that if somebody's attacking me, I don't have to use force against them except for compliance. So that's the beautiful thing about the art of jiu-jitsu, is that I don't have to hurt somebody, but I also can have complete control of a situation whenever somebody's trying to be violent towards me. So that's just a little bit of insight for me on the situation.
Yeah, in any fear-induced situation, like a self-defense situation, jiu-jitsu can definitely help you through. I'm a correctional officer outside of here. I've been in many unplanned uses of forces, and I've been able to maintain composure in those situations a lot better than what I used to be. I used to walk around with anxiety. I had a little fear of those situations happening. I pre-planned for them, but jiu-jitsu teaches you that we're not very good at forecasting how future events happen. The more we train this, the more we end up in situations of, well, I expected this, but it didn't happen that way.
Right. So I was going to say, have you ever had to use it outside of the gym situation?
Actually, I just heard a story not too long ago from Tommy. He's a gentleman that teaches the morning classes here. He just had to use his skill set at work. He works with Paul. He's a correctional officer also. And he had a situation where there's an attack going on, and he utilizes jiu-jitsu and had complete control of the situation, and nobody got hurt, and everything was good.
Cool. So this place is huge. This is a pretty impressive gym you guys got going on. Tell me a little bit about your gym here and how this came to be and what you guys offer here and all that kind of stuff.
Well, we came to this location because we were over on Wayne Avenue originally, and we were getting flooded out. So we decided to make a move, and we needed a space that we could have safe training for everyone. And so we set up over here, and we have about 100 foot of wrestling mats, about 100 by 25, I'd say. And we also have a 24-hour fitness, so that way our members can utilize either the martial arts side of things or the 24-hour side of things to work on whatever goal they choose.
Do you guys offer classes other than jiu-jitsu, or is it just jiu-jitsu?
No, we teach youth and adult Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, is both forms, gi and no-gi grappling. We also teach mixed martial arts, and we have IUP students. We've had a couple other folk from the local area fight for us in the cage, so they cage fight. So if you ever watch UFC, that's the biggest promotion for mixed martial arts. So we teach that, and we also teach kickboxing for adults here.
Cool. So someone comes in here for the first time, and we'll put all the information up, and it'll be made available to people. But So the first time I come in, I've never done anything. A, what do I show up with? B, what can I expect? Because again, it's intimidating walking here. So what's going to happen my first day, and what should I come prepared with?
First day, you're going to come in, you're going to meet the team.
Okay.
You know, you're going to sign a waiver, come in wearing athletic attire. And the biggest thing is bringing a good attitude. You know, we're all here, and that's something that we value on our mats, is a safe training environment, because our goal at the end of the day is to give our training partners the most amount of work, but not disrespect them.
Okay. Cool. So just come in with a good attitude. Do I have anything to be scared of? Am I going to get hurt? Are people going to beat me up if I'm new? I don't know what I'm doing.
Our classes here are very family oriented, and we have skill sets that range from brand new to somebody that's been doing martial arts all their life. So when you come in, everybody has an attitude in here to help somebody else progress, so they have just as sharp of a sword as they are, so that they can train and maybe compete or be prepared for those life situations that they need their self-defense.
Awesome. Well, like I said, we will provide all the information. I think we're going to get some footage of you guys training and see exactly what's going on here. And just want to thank you guys so much for your time. And yeah, best of luck.
Feel free to look around, too.
Yeah, we'll look around. So again, Coach Brian and Coach Paul, the owners here of Elite Combative Systems, I want to thank them, and we'll see you soon.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you.
Cool.
Thanks, Steve.
Yeah, you got it, guys.